It's no secret that these days the news can be a bit overwhelming. I mean, if Edgar Allan Poe were around today, he'd probably tell Wolf Blitzer to lighten up. Breaking news from the White House, an unnamed Trump aide has just confirmed, life has no meaning. Now let's go to the panel and screw it. Discuss some tweets. That's why today I want to take some time out to discuss some good news out of California, a state that recently chose to stop burning fossil fuels. Possibly because it's California, and after those fires, they've just ran out of things to burn. I mean, communes in San Francisco can only use copies of The Art of the Deal for so long before they completely run out of fuel. So today, we're looking into California Senate Bill 100. Ooh, round number for once, to see just what type of economics this plan has.
Today, we announce an important next step in California's climate leadership. Senate Bill 100 puts California on the path to 100% clean energy, renewable energy, by 2045.
California is going to be entirely renewable by 2045? Despite the fact that they could probably accomplish this simply by implementing an out-of-work actors on treadmills regime, it seems like they're going for more of a scientific method. This is no small deal either. In signing it into law, it will become the most significant political jurisdiction in the world to commit to 100% clean electricity by a wide margin. Now, most people, especially those that don't pay California state taxes and utilities, are overjoyed by this. So without further ado, let's open up Senate Bill 100. I want to get straight to the source, because with alternate energy comes alternate facts.
Gasoline is not considered a renewable power. Therefore, when they say 100% renewable power, what they are saying is that it is their intention to ban all electricity and gasoline by the year 2045.
Man, if you want anyone to listen, you have to take off that shirt that says conspiracy, I said to the guy with 32,000 views. Unfortunately, he's one of the few people covering this, and while banning electricity and gasoline would be one strategy for getting to renewables only, that's like cutting off your legs to win a weight loss competition. The first thing to know about this bill is that this idea didn't just come out of nowhere. In fact, previously, California was scheduled to be at 50% renewable electricity by December 31st, 2030. They're just doing such a good job with renewables that this bill moved that 50% deadline forward 4 years, and then said, yeah, we'll now be at 60% by that time. And here I am thinking that the only time the government over-delivers is in creating a military budget. We're not talking small numbers here either.
Californians would be surprised to know that right now we're probably generating between 30 to 40% of our electricity today from clean energy sources like wind and solar.
Dan Jacobson is state director for Environment California. He notes that on one hot, sunny Saturday last month, California actually hit 80% renewable energy.
So by 2030, getting up to 60% is going to be very easy for us to do.
80%? That's amazing, but also pretty volatile. Yeah, we usually hover around 30% renewable energy, but on a good day it's 80%. Let's just hope people stay in when it's sunny and head out when it's raining. Some aren't too pleased with this, because planning your life around the Weather Channel isn't as fun as it sounds. California does have a solution to this beyond rely on future generations to try and make better energy storage devices than my proposed pit of rechargeable batteries. Products not included. Their solution is, well, it's a little deceptive because they're using zero carbon resources. These include renewables along with baseload renewables like geothermal and some biomass. But they're also including large hydro, nuclear power, or natural gas with carbon capture and storage. So yeah, some of that sounded about as sustainable as anger towards a puppy. I mean, you're not about to see the Green Party candidate getting on stage and advocating burning natural gas and burying the CO2. But it's a zero-emission energy source. This is receiving a ton of bipartisan support.
76% of California's strong majorities of both Democrats as well as Republicans want California to move toward a 100% clean energy future.
53% of Republicans supported that. Well, that's pretty significant. Although, I have a feeling that California Republicans might be a little more liberal. The combination of ocean and legal weed tends to bring that side out of people. It was able to garner such broad support, though, by making specific that its desire was not dumping poison into the air we breathe. A topic that remains pretty uncontroversial amongst the majority non-suicidal part of our nation. So, how is California doing this? Well, this is where things get controversial. The bill would require that retail sellers and local publicly owned electric utilities procure a minimum quantity of electricity products from eligible renewable energy resources. This would scale up over time until providers would be required to buy all clean energy, which, yep, that's legal in California. Not everyone is happy about this because, unfortunately, no policy is without its losers.
My question, I think, is on a lot of people's minds. Of course, we all want to have clean air. Of course, we want clean standards. But how do we go back to our constituents and justify the cost increases?
Yeah, zero emissions isn't free, or at least setting it up isn't free. I feel like once the panels, turbines, and dams are up, if electricity still is more expensive, that's more of a your provider's ripping you off situation. But still, the initial cost of all this is not cheap, and some people don't want to pay extra to avoid ingesting low-level poisons. And you know what? The Democrat response to that question, while confident, wasn't great.
According to the United States Energy Information Agency, we actually are 44th in the entire nation with regards to the cost of utility bills.
He kept going back to the fact that California has some of the lowest utility bills in the country, a fact that sounds relevant until you think about it. That's like saying, well, I have a clean bill of health so I can afford to do some drugs. The problem for critics is the change in costs, not how objectively cheap things are. Still though, most people are behind this plan because it allows for non-renewable yet reliable and clean forms of electricity, like nuclear and carbon capture and storage-backed natural gas. So, to give you guys an idea of how this act is doing, it did pass the Senate and Assembly and is now sitting at the governor's desk, where it's encountering a slight problem.
There's no quick one thing you can do. This is going to be a long march to transition the entire modern world to a decarbonized future. So it's big, it's important, and we're doing it in California.
That's so inspiring. Sounds like he's really behind the cause. Well, Governor Brown is threatening to veto SB 100 if legislators don't also pass AB 813, a bill that would set California on the path to joining a larger regional Western power market. Governor Brown has been trying to link the two bills for a while in the legislative equivalent of me showing up to a nightclub with a supermodel. Yeah, I'm not passing on my own, but together, now we're talking. Unfortunately for him, recently these two bills have become disconnected. And while the bill that pushes for 100% non-carbon producing energy production on California's grid passed, AB 813 will not be moved to the Senate floor for vote this year. We will continue the important discussion next year. Basically, the geopolitical bouncer just said, "Hey, you back of the line, buddy!" So all eyes are on Jerry Brown right now to see if he will lend his signature. And when I say all eyes, I mean me and a bunch of people who think this is going to ban cars and all electricity. And I'd be laughing harder, but they have tens of thousands of views and are the first things to come up when you search this bill on YouTube. So quick side note, if you've made it this far, please share and like so that the real facts on this bill can compete with all the crap that floated to the top. To conclude on a high note,
now we've gone from virtually zero to nearly 50% clean energy in less than 20 years. And we've created hundreds of thousands of good, clean energy jobs in the process. All the evidence suggests 100% clean energy is in fact within reach.
Yeah, California is doing something that I would have bet my college savings on being impossible and approaching 100% clean energy. It might not be perfect, and some people might not agree on the politics of climate change, but just the fact that the world's fifth largest economy, yeah, that's right, Britain, maybe replace that tea with coffee and hit the bricks, looks like it will successfully be doing this, is huge. So congratulations, California, on, again, being the most significant political jurisdiction in the world to take this step by a wide margin. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. And remember to click that bell so freedom will continue to ring. Remember to give me a thumbs up, and as always, thank you for watching.